Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursaleen, nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters. I hope you guys are doing well. Hope that you guys are, inshallah, is doing well. So, brothers and sisters, yeah, a lot of the time people come up to us and they say to us, we saying, how's life been? Or what have you been up to? And a lot of the time we respond and we were guilty of this, wallahi, we forget this year, but sometimes we respond with negativity and we complain about this, and we complain about uni and our family, whatever it may be. We point out all the negativity stuff, all the negative aspects about our day and our life. And this is what I want to speak to you guys about today, yeah? So if we look into the Surah Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, you'll see so many things went wrong in his life, brothers and sisters. Right from the beginning, when his brothers tried plotting and they planned, they tried to dash him down the world and try to kill him. And then when he became the slave of Al-Aziz, and Aziz tried to rape and seduce him. And then when he was chucked in prison for doing absolutely nothing, he was chucked in prison. And then right at the very end, when his brothers came back and tried to deceive and lie him. So many things went wrong in his life. But right at the very end, when he was finally united with his family, his dad, his brothers, and he had to sum up his life. And I want you guys to imagine one of his family, just imagine one of his family member asking him, yo, how's life been, man? Yusuf, chat to us, man. What's life saying? How did you end up here? Listen to the way he responds. Listen to how he sums up his life, subhanAllah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sums it up in one verse in the Quran. Right from the beginning, brothers and sisters, Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he says, وَقَدْ أَحَسَنَ بِي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been good to me. He's letting his family know, yo, think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're here because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're not here because of something that we did. He's basically removing all the pride and arrogance that they must have had at the time. He's saying, yo, get rid of all of that. We're here because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been good to us. So think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Well, because we're here because of his blessings and his bounty, subhanAllah. Then he goes on to say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took me out of prison. Now I want to ask you guys, brothers and sisters, yeah, why did Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, why did he say Allah took me out of prison? Why didn't he mention Allah put me in prison and then Allah took me out of prison? Of all the other things that went wrong in his life, why didn't he mention it? Why didn't he mention my brother tried to dash me down the wall and try to kill me, but yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved me? Al-Aziz actually tried to rape me, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected me. My brothers came at the end and they tried to deceive me, but Allah exposed them. Why didn't he mention these things? Why did he specifically mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took me out of prison? Brothers and sisters, listen to this here. The scholars of Tafsir, they mentioned the most burdensome, the most hardest part of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, his life was when he was in prison. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't even mention the Quran how long he was there chilling in prison for. So what in reality what he's doing is that he's turning the worst part of his life and he's turning it into a positive thing. And then the very next part after that, he goes to his family, look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took you out of the Bedouin life that you had. The life that you had, and he brought you here to Egypt. And a Bedouin, brother and sister, is someone who lives outside civilization, lives inside in the desert, in the countryside or something. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you here in Egypt now. Look at the chance, look at the difference in life, you're here now. And I've got authority, man's got power, I've got money, I've got pee. I can give you palaces, we're about to live a good life, subhanAllah. So right from the beginning, Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, he goes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been good to me. And then he turns the worst part of his life into a positive thing by saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took me out of prison. Then he looks at his family and says, yo, the worst part of your life is that you guys were Bedouins. But now you're here, now turning their worst part of their life into a positive thing, subhanAllah. Look at the optimism of the awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. SubhanAllah, man. So what Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam teaches us, brothers and sisters, is that we should say and do things that will not only get us to think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but have the people around us also think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And brothers and sisters, before I end this video, I want to quickly mention one quick other thing here. When a practicing brother or sister comes up to us and they say to us, yo, how's life? What are you saying? What's good? And we respond with all this negativity, because these guys are practicing, they'll understand, yo, this is sabr. I mean, this is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have sabr, don't worry, you'll get through this. But if someone jahil comes to us and says to us, yo, how's life? And we respond with all this negativity, brothers and sisters, by Allah, these guys are going to think, they're going to think bad of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're going to think, why is Allah doing this? Allah's a bad person. Why is Allah doing this? This guy is such a good person. This sister and this brother is such a good person. Why is Allah punishing them? Why is Allah giving them such a dead life? And this is what Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam is teaching us. That when you say good things, people will think good of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, I hope you guys, inshallah, enjoy this new series, and I hope inshallah you guys enjoy this video. Remember, as always, like I told you guys, take one beneficial point out of the video and try to act upon it. And if you guys haven't, click the subscribe button below, make sure you guys do that. And I'm gonna leave you guys here until the next video. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Yeah.